Welcome to Violin Lounge TV, where you learn to play the violin and viola with body, mind and spirit. This is your host, violinist Zlata.
Hello, this video is the first video of three videos that cover 12 tips to play in tune on the violin and viola. We could probably write books full of information about this and create loads of DVD boxes. So I try to cover just kind of the tip of the iceberg. Playing a tune, or as we say it, intonation, is one of the most difficult things on the violin or viola. Of course, we have a fingerboard that is maybe a great unknown in the beginning. And besides that, we have to adjust to our musical environment. It's different to play with a piano, or in a piano trio, or in a string quartet, or in an orchestra. You have to continuously adjust to what is happening. In this video, I will share with you the first four tips. The first tip is to be able to imagine the notes you want to play. If there is a note that you can't just reach, and you can't reach it time after time, then just before you play it, imagine it in your head. Like you can hear a tune in your head, this is musical imagination, you can also imagine the notes you want to play. Remember that the ear commands and the hand follows. Violin playing isn't just a motor skill. You really have to know what you want to play, and sometimes, like magic, your hand will follow. What you will discover is that when you have a note you can't reach time after time and it's wrong, then you probably don't have the melody or that note correctly in your head. Maybe you can try it with some pieces. That you look at the note, you imagine the sound in your head, and then you play it and see if it matches. Then tip number two is to study scales. Scales help you to improve your feeling of tonality and to improve your intonation and also bowing. Because the scales are kind of a playground where you can practice your intonation as a separate technique outside pieces. And the same is for bowing. There are on all levels different ways to practice scales. Perhaps you can look around for a scale book that fits your current level. Then tip number three is to know what you play. What I see a lot with students is they don't really can make the translation from the sharps and flats, so the key they are playing in, to fingerings. So see if you really understand which, for example, second fingers have to be low, which ones have to be high, how this is in position play, if that's applicable. So really know what you have to play and don't just coincidentally drop your fingers and see if it's right. And then after some bars, have the feeling that something's off, but you don't really know. So it can get you great results to just look at the piece and try to imagine all the fingerings on the fingerboard. Really understand what the note names are and what the fingerings are of the notes you are playing. The fourth tip is to see how you place your fingers. Analyze how you have to place your fingers. And this is different per person, so you really have to analyze that for yourself. For example, for me, a low fourth finger is kind of round. Some people always say you have to put your fourth finger flat, some say you always have to keep it round, but you can do both. When my fourth finger is normal, it is something between round and flat. And when it's high, it's almost flat. So find out what this is for you. In positions, it can be again different. Just to summarize the four tips. Tip one was imagine the sounds, the ear commands and the hand follows. Tip number 2 was play scales. Tip number 3 was know what you play. And tip number 4 is analyze how you place your fingers. I hope this is useful for you. Try to implement this when you are practicing. If you like this video, then please like it and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye!
Thank you for watching Violin Lounge TV. Zlata has a gift for you. The free workshop, Weight versus Pressure. In this, she will teach you how to play the violin or viola effortlessly and comfortably. The secrets to creating a beautiful tone and to touch people's hearts with your violin or viola playing. Weight versus Pressure includes the 30-minute video masterclass, Weight versus Pressure, the 44-page workshop binder, and the Weight versus Pressure body scan you can do yourself. People use it as a valuable reference for years. Go to www.violinlounge.com/free-workshop. Fill out your name and email address, go to your email inbox to confirm, and Zlata will send you the login details for the workshop within 1 hour. Enjoy happy practicing and beautiful playing.